Good evening and aloha. Today is November 3rd, and I have a meeting at Honolulu Television, and I just came back from Oahu. And today the meeting is about the project, planning of projects for the anniversary commemoration of our Jodisho founding. In 2019, we will celebrate 125th anniversary since founding of Jodisho. And for the memorial year in 2019, we are now planning for the new project. And one of the projects is that to make CD of chanting English sutras. And today, I want to test wireless microphone. And so far, my YouTube video was easy for me, very easy for uploading the video because this is live streaming and I had no preparation. Usually take a video and to connect to the computer and then upload the data. But this live streaming, I can just, no preparation is necessary. I don't need to connect to the computer. Just a few clicks, I can broadcast the video to the world. So for me, very easy. But the one thing that I don't like was the quality of the video and the quality of the sound was not good. So hopefully, with this wireless microphone, I hope the sound maybe improved. So I don't know, this is kind of a test. So today's was of Honen Shonin is from the illustrated biography of Honen Shonin called Gyojo Ezu, Honen Shonin Gyojo Ezu, from chapter 31. And the theme, the title is The Holy Gate and Pure Land Gate. And this is actually one of the favorites. And yesterday, you know, the title was that to establish the teaching, the doctrine, to establish the doctrine and founding of Jodosho. And, you know, in the beginning part of Buddhist practice, Honen Shonin pursues ultimate wisdom. However, because he realized that he couldn't observe the precepts and his concentration was not good, he realized that. Then he turned through the pursue or seek for the wisdom to the salvation, to the birth of the Pure Land. And today is kind of to follow up his turning point, the Holy Gate and the Pure Land Gate. And this is also a very short passage, but this also includes the very important concept of equality, equality of the human being. And this is 13th century, but Honen Shonin realized that everybody should be equal. You know, that clearly written. So this is kind of very touching. So let me read. Someone once said to Honen Shonin, you are every utterance is in accord with the intent of Buddha Amitabha. Honen Shonin asked, what do you mean? You are then told, since you are a land priest, you fully understand the merits of the name of Buddha Amitabha and have distinctly mastered the profound meaning of the essential vow of Buddha Amitabha. Honen Shonin replied, you do not yet believe in the essential vow. The recitation of the name of Buddha Amitabha taught in the essential vow was designed for all people, including the woodcutter, grass trimmer, farmer, water carrier, regardless of class or knowledge. If one family believes that even a literate, a attains persons of pure love through reciting the name of Buddha Amitabha. Sincerely desire births in the pure and repeats the name of Buddha Amitabha unceasingly. He is considered to be the ultimate devotee for births in the pure life. If we can detach ourselves from the delusive world of transmigration of births and deaths by pursuing wisdom, why would I again for them have abandoned the holy gate to follow the teaching of pure life gate? Bonen Shomu further stated, it should be known that the practice of the holy gate endeavors to extricate one from the delusive world through the pursuit of wisdom, and that the pure land gate teaches one to return to a state of good chi in order to be born in the land of ultimate bliss. So in the last sentence in Japanese, 超道門の修行は自由を極めて少女派、and 浄土門の修行は愚痴に帰って極楽に往生する。So this is the essence of what is holy gate and what is pure land gate, the 浄土 gate. So yes, just like yesterday, you know, the ultimate traditional Buddhism is precepts, meditation, and wisdom. And this is to attain the ultimate wisdom. The three steps are essential. But the Jodomon, the pure land gate, that you don't need concentrated mind. You don't need precepts. Because that is Amida Buddha's wish, Amida Buddha's power, that we need to believe. So we don't need wisdom, actually. But we are realize that, we can realize we are very ignorant and we are imperfect. Because we are imperfect, Amida Buddha can save us. So this is the pure land gate. And over here it clearly states that 超道門の修行は知恵を極めて少女派だ。So the purpose of the holy gate, the practice of holy gate or sacred path is actually one word, to leave the world of transmigration of birth and death, to leave the reincarnation. That is the purpose. How? To seek for the wisdom. So wisdom, by having wisdom, you can detach oneself from the delusive worlds of transmigration or birth and death. So this is very traditional idea, and Honen Shoji followed, you know, Master Tao Cha, Doshaku, Jodomon, Shodomon. So this is Shodomon, the holy gate teaching. So this is one way. And another way is that Jodomon, no Shugyowa. So the practice of pure land gate is to return to awareness of ignorance and to return to realization of imperfect nature. Then we wish, we aspire for the birth in the pure land. So that is that Honen Shoji seeked, and that is from the religion of wisdom to the turning to the religion of salvation or religion of saving. So that one, Honen Shoji's idea clearly stated. Then there is another passage, that is one of the famous passages, that それ速やかに少女を離れると思わば二種の称号のうちしばらく小道門を差し置いて浄土門に入れ。 So this is a kind of very similar But the purpose of, you know, if you wish to leave the delusive world, so this sentence, you know, another passage that, それ速やかに生じを離れんと思わば、二種の消防のうち、しばらく聖堂門を差し置きて浄土門に行って、so if you wish to leave this reincarnation, you can put aside the holy gate and go enter the pure land gate. So this is the meaning of それ速やかに生じを離れんと思わば、二種の消防のうちしばらく聖堂門を差し置きて浄土門に行って、if you want to leaveThe delusive words of transmigration, then you put aside the holy gate. And this is kind of a contradiction. Well, over here today says that the holy gate is to leave the delusive world, right? But in another passage that if you wish to leave the delusive world, go enter the pure land, go enter the pure land gate.And you can put aside the holy gate. And this sound contradiction for a long time, I had a question, but today I got it. It was so touching. And because there is one key word. So, それ速やかに生じを離れんと思わば。So the key word is,速やか、and 速やかに means immediately. So in another passage that if you immediately want to leave this transmigration, reincarnation, if you immediately leave reincarnation, then you can put aside the holy gate and go enter the Jodo, the Pure Land Gate. And in this sentence, there is also another keyword is Nishu no Shoubo no Uchi. So two kinds of Shoubo, and two kinds of Shoubo, and two kinds indicate that Pure Land Gate and Holy Gate. And Shoubo, what is the meaning of Shoubo is that excellent Dharma, excellent teaching. So, Holy Nation admits both Pure Land Gate and Holy Gate are excellent gate. So, they expressed, Holy Nation expressed two kinds of that is Holy Gate and Pure Land Gate are both excellent teaching. But if you wish immediately, so immediately, you know, the big difference that. So if you put immediately, so if you wish to immediately detach oneself from the delusive worlds, then you put aside the holy gate and go enter the pure land. And today's passage is, there is no word 速やかに or immediately. So this, you know, 聖道門の修行は知恵を極めて生じを離れ。So this, the practice of Holy Gate is to pursue the wisdom, to seek for the wisdom. And it indicates that it takes time.It takes time because this is difficult. And even the Master Honen couldn't pursue the wisdom because he realized that are too difficult, especially for the common people, too difficult. So he admits this is a too difficult the gate. So same thing that, you know, to detach oneself from the delusive worlds of transmigration, birth and death,Same thing, but if you wish immediately, you know, to leave that delusive world, then difficult practice is no good, because difficult practice takes time, so that's not good. So immediately is pure out gate, because that is Amida Buddha's wish, Amida Buddha's aspiration. We just follow, we just leave ourselves to the Buddha Amitabha. We can just take refuge in Amida Buddha so easy. Then we can immediately, you know, attain the path of pure. And that one, immediately attain the path of pure is that your face, when your face settle. So the moment your face settle, then you can, that I think, meaning of immediately. So, and one more thing that the, in the beginning part, that, you know, Honenshoni, your Nembutsu is very wondrous. And your Nembutsu, you know, must be that Amida Buddha is very happy to hear your Nembutsu. And Honenshoni asked, what do you mean? You know, why Amida Buddha happy to hear my Nembutsu? And then, you know, the question followed and continued that, because you are learned priest, because you are wise, so wise, and you know the deep meaning of Nembutsu, and then you recite Namo Amida Butsu. That is a reason that your Nembutsu is superior, your Nembutsu is excellent. And Amida Buddha really happy to hear Nembutsu. Then Honenshoni said, you know, replied to the question, oh, you haven't believed, you have not believed the essential path yet. You know, the Nembutsu I recite, Nembutsu you recite, the Nembutsu whoever recite should be same, should be same. In front of Amida Buddha. You know, in front of Amida Buddha, we are all ignorant. We are all ignorant. We are all Guji. You know. So we should be equal. So because we are all equal, our Nembutsu should be equal. That Honenshoni clearly states, this is the equality, equality of human being. And his life is actually proof that his sort of equality, because he taught the teaching of Nembutsu, you know, to the noble people, like the imperial princess, and to the homeless people, whoever, you know, everybody. He wanted to save everybody. So behind, you know, the salvation of everybody is he thinks, he truly, truly, deeply, deeply realizes that human being should be equal. We should be equal. So the equality, the sort of equality that Honenshoni realized. Sorry, I talk too much. Today, the Holy Gate and the Pure Land Gate, once again, during chanting of Ostome, I want to read again the Holy Gate and Pure Land Gate. And today's sutra is Meditation Sutra. Kammuryojuke, the visualization of Amida Buddha meditation. Pure as an incense burner. I aspire for my mind to be like the light of wisdom. With every thought, I burn this incense of discipline and meditation to dedicate myself to the past, present, and future Buddhas of the Ten Directions. I wholeheartedly take refuge in the Buddhas, who eternally dwells in the land of the Ten Directions. I wholeheartedly take refuge in the Dharma of the teachings, which eternally exist in the land of the Ten Directions. I wholeheartedly take refuge in the Sangha, the community, which eternally exists in the land of the Ten Directions. We reverently call upon Amida Buddha, the world honored one, to enter this sacred place. We reverently call upon Shakyamuni Tathagata, the enlightened one, to enter this sacred place. We reverently call upon the Tathagatas of the Ten Directions to enter this sacred place. The harmful actions I have done in the past are all derived from my inherent greed, anger, and delusion. Born of my conduct, words, and thoughts, I now repent them all. Namu Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu. Namu Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu, Ami, Namu, Namu Ami, Namu. And the first profound and wondrous Dharma, even after 100,000 million eons, is deeper to encounter. We now hear, receive, and uphold it. May we understand the true message of the Tathagata. The visualization of Amida Buddha. The Buddha said to Ananda and Vaidehi, when these perceptions are achieved, you should next visualize the physical attributes and radiant light of the Buddha of immeasurable life, Amida Yus. Ananda, you should know that the body of Amida Yus Buddha is as glorious as 100,000 million pieces of gold in the Jambu River of the Yamaha. His height, 6 trillion miles, is as countless as the sands of the Ganges. The white depth of hair between his eyebrows, covering to the right, is like 5 mountains. The Buddha's eyes, like the waters of the four great oceans, the blue and white are distinct. Every form of his body radiates bright light like monk's smoke. The Buddha's aureole is as expansive as 10 billion of the 3,000 great southern worlds, and within this brown aura are hundreds of thousands of millions, as countless as the sands of the Ganges of transformation Buddhas. Each of these Buddha manifestations also has an assembly of countless manifestations of bodhisattvas as attendants. The Buddha of infinite life and interuse has 84,000 major marks. Each of these attributes also has 84,000 minor marks of excess. And each of these also has 84,000 rays of light. Each ray universally shines upon the realms in the 10 directions, embracing and never forsaking all living beings, calling Amida Buddha's name. His light, physical attributes, marks, and transformation Buddhas cannot be fully explained. Only through deep contemplation can you see them in the mind's eyes. If you experience this, you will see all the Buddhas of the 10 directions. This ability to see all the Buddhas is called Nembutsu Samadhi. Forming this visualization is called visualization of the bodies of all the Buddhas. By envisioning the Buddha's body, you also see the Buddha's mind. The Buddha's mind is great compassion itself, embracing all beings with unconditional compassion. Those who practice this visualization discard their bodies for the other world, shall be born before all the Buddhas and realize the insight of non-variety. For this reason, the wise one direct their souls to clearly envision Amida Yus, the Buddha of immeasurable life. To visualize the Buddha of immeasurable life, begin with one attribute and mark. First, simply visualize the white tuft of hair between his eyebrows until it appears perfectly clear. When you see the white tuft of hair between his eyebrows, the 84,000 attributes and marks will naturally appear. As you see the Buddhas of immeasurable life, you will also see the immeasurable Buddhas of the 10 directions. Having gained the vision of immeasurable Buddhas with all the Buddhas before you, you will receive the prediction of your future enlightenment. This complete visualization of all the physical features of the Buddha's body called the ninth visualization. To practice in this way is called right visualization. Any other practice is called unorthodox visualization. Amida Buddha's original vows are the essential gate to the ultimate bliss. May this merit be transferred equally to enable us immediately attain birth in the pure. Namu Ami Namu Namu Ami Namu Namu Ami Namu Namu Ami Namu Ami Namu Namu Ami Namu Namu Ami Namu ある人を承認の坊させたも念仏は念々ごとに仏の御心にかない騒乱など申しけるいかなれば徳承認返し問われければ記者にてはしませば明後の功徳をも詳しく示し本願の様をも明らかに本心へやる
南自本願を信ずることまだしかりけり、何よらいも本願の名号は木こに草刈り、夏に水くむ類いごときのものの、内下ともにかけて一文普通なるがとなうれは、必ず生まると信じて真実に願いて常に念仏申すを最上の気とする。もし知恵を持ちて少女を離れるべくは、元気いかでかかの小道門を捨ててこの浄土門に赴くべきや、小道門の修行は知恵を極めて少女を離れ、浄土門の修行は愚痴に帰りて極楽に埋まると知るべしと仰せられける。
Day three, the holy gate and the pure gate. Someone once said to Honen Shoryu, "You are every utterance of the Nembutsu of Buddha Amitabha is in accord with the intent of Buddha Amitabha." Honen Shoryu asked, "What do you mean?" He was then told, "Since you are a land priest, you fully understand the merits of the name of Buddha Amitabha and have distinctly mastered the profound meaning of the essential vow of Buddha Amitabha." Honen Shoryu replied, "You do not yet believe in the essential vow. The recitation of the name of Buddha Amitabha taught in the essential vow was designed for all people, including the woodcutter, grass trimmer, farmer, water carrier, regardless of class or knowledge. If one family believe that even an illiterate attains birth in the pure, through reciting the name of Buddha Amitabha, sincerely desires birth in the pure, and repeats the name of Buddha Amitabha unceasingly, he is considered to be the ultimate devotee for birth in the pure. If we can detach ourselves from the delusive words of the transmigration of birth and death, pursuing wisdom, why could I, Genku, have abandoned the holy gate to follow the teaching of the Pure Land Gate?" Honen Shoryu further stated, "It should be known that the practice of the holy gate endeavors to extricate one from the delusive world through the pursuit of wisdom, and that Pure Land Gate teaches one to return to a state of Guji in order to be born in the land of ultimate." The infinite light of Amida Buddha illuminates the 10 directions of the world, and all who call upon his name shall be received and never abandoned. No,
I revere the king of the great compassionate worlds, Amida Buddha, the dispatcher and founder of the teaching Shakyamuni Buddha, all the Buddhas, as many as the sons of the Ganges in the six directions, Kannon, Seishi, all the great bodhisattvas, the world ascendability, and ultimately the being of the pure and the great ocean, and the three treasures and the great compassion. May there be harmony below the heavens with the sun and the moon shining brightly. May the wind and rain be timely and disasters and calamity not arise. May nations be bountiful and people safe, and armies and weapons not be used. Let us revere marriage and humanity and cultivate respect and humility. Our High Patriarch Komyo, the Great Master Shantao, our founder, the Great Master Enko, Tozen, Ejo, Okaku, Jikyo, Meisho, Wajun Komi, Taishi, Honen Shoni, the Second Patriarch, Natural Teacher, Taisho, Shoju, Shoko Shoni, the Third Patriarch, the Recording and Meditation Master, Kishu, Yochu Shoni, the light of transmitting the pure end of the three countries and all the great patriarchs by realizing the compassionate blessing of Amida Buddha. Namu Amida Buddha, 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 Namu Amida Buddha. The founding master of our temple, Reverend Jitsujo Muroyama, Reverend Gintetsu Hangada, Reverend Tatsuyu Yoshida, Reverend Shozan Kato, Reverend Kenjo Ito, Reverend Yukai Yamaguchi, Reverend Shuzui Hino, Reverend Noshin Hayashi, Reverend Kenjo Urakami, the Nestor and all the priests who serve this temple with a Bugen practice will achieve heart enlightenment to return to this world from the Pure Land to guide us again. We again offer my prayers to my teachers, ministers, to my parsal and mother, to all the temple members, donors, and all living beings with whom I have a karmic connection. May all those who are living experience joy, prosperity, and longevity without limit. May those who have died escape from suffering and transcend to be born into the pure mind. We pray for the peace and stability of our temple and for complete affinity with the parents. May we be completely free from hindrances and cultivate our practice on the Buddhist paths. Since the founding of this temple, to all the members, daily and monthly memorial tablets, the recently deceased, those in intermediate stage of existence, and to all spirits, may we cultivate virtuous merit so that they may be enlightened. We aspire for these merits and virtues to be equally bestowed upon all. And may we together develop the aspiration for enlightenment to achieve verbs in the pure land of peace and peace. However, innumerable sentient beings are, I earnestly vow to enlighten them all. However, inexhaustible delusions are, I earnestly vow to extinguish them all. However immeasurable the Buddha's teachings are, I earnestly vow to comprehend them all. However incomparable enlightenment is, I earnestly vow to attain it by all means. I sincerely wish to share the blessing with all beings. Together we are born into the pure land of ultimate bliss to achieve the way of the may we now call upon all the Buddhas to return to their lands. We offer incense and flowers in appreciation to send them off. We ask for your compassionate guidance and protection. May those who have gone before us to encourage us to attain birth in the pure light.
Thank you very much. I hope this microphone works good. Again, thank you very much. And see you tomorrow.